Hi everyone, welcome to Making Lemonade. I'm your host, Noa Rodriguez-Hoffman. On today's episode, we're talking to Dr. Wendy Brown. From NFL cheerleader to biomedical engineer, inventor, and entrepreneur, Wendy challenged stereotypes and proved that you can do and be anything you want to be. Get ready to be inspired as she shares her playbook to success. Wendy, thank you so much for being on the show today. How are you?
Great. Thank you for having me.
How did you get into cheerleading and what led you to do it professionally?
I danced all growing up, even into college. I was on my college's dance team. My coach was this intelligent, kind, successful person. She was a financial advisor. And at the time, cheered for the Atlanta Falcons. And I was like, oh my gosh, I want to be like her. And she was just such a role model for me that my senior year, I auditioned for the Atlanta Falcons and made it out of 400 people onto a team of 30 to 40. It was an incredible experience.
That's amazing. How did you balance the demands of cheerleading for the Falcons while still trying to finish your degree?
I was really lucky with the Falcons because they appreciated women who had careers and other interests. And so their practices were later in the day to accommodate people with full-time jobs. School and cheerleading were really important to me. And so I had the motivation to do both.
And so you graduated from Georgia Tech in 2011, right? What was your degree in?
So I graduated with a Bachelor's of Science in Biomedical Engineering, a minor in Spanish, and a certificate in organizational leadership. And I also did an undergraduate research thesis.
After undergrad, you moved across the country to pursue your PhD from UC Davis. Why UC Davis?
They were a great engineering school. They had a person who was an expert in cartilage there that I wanted to work with. Also, they were in the Bay Area, surrounded by professional sports teams because they knew I wanted to keep cheering. So when I moved there, I cheered 1 year for the Sacramento Kings. I realized how much I missed football. I ultimately wound up cheering 4 years for the Oakland Raiders. I retired in 2017 after 4 years with the Raiders, cheering 7 years professionally total. And I feel really fortunate that I was able to make the voluntary decision to retire because I know a lot of people are forced out from injuries. I was ready to hang up the palms and hang up the boots, as they say, and ready to give my spot up to somebody younger and really enthusiastic because I had such a great experience. I wanted to cheer on my Raiderette sisters from the other side of the sideline.
Right, because you've mentioned how pivotal having the support of a mentor was for your career in the NFL.
Yeah, mentorship is extremely important to me. In particular, when I was in college, I shadowed a doctor, a female doctor in Atlanta, who was a chemical engineering major from my school at the time she was there, was the feature twirler, went on to medical school, and in medical school was crowned Miss Georgia, you know, in the 1970s. And she was living proof that you can be successful at whatever you set your mind to, whether that's science, pageants, twirling, dancing, even things that seem completely separate from each other. You can do both no matter what.
You went on to co-found a startup, Cartilage Inc., where you and your team are actually developing a cartilage implant that will revolutionize the way we treat injuries like knee and hip replacements. That's super cool. Tell me more about that.
So just a little bit of background on cartilage. It's all over your body. It's in your joints, your nose, even your ribs, and it acts as a slippery shock absorber. The bad thing about cartilage is that it doesn't heal once it's injured. By the time you're in your 60s or 70s, you'll probably need a metal and plastic knee replacement because that cartilage damage has deteriorated so much. So we are trying to develop these cartilage engineering technologies to generate healthy living cartilage that then we can give back to a person's injury and hopefully completely heal it and prevent them from needing a knee replacement later in life.
And one of the reasons that you're able to fund your research is because you were the recipient of the 2020 L'Oreal for Women in Science Fellowship Award, right?
Yes, this fellowship is giving me the resources to also study and engineer nose cartilage, which is another greatly needed but greatly understudied area. It's also giving me the resources to mentor other young women in science.
And you've been doing this mentorship work through a nonprofit called Science Cheerleaders, where you're the director of outreach. Who are the Science Cheerleaders?
The Science Cheerleaders is a national nonprofit organization of over 300 current and former professional cheerleaders, and we all have degrees and careers in science and STEM fields. And our goal is to mentor and lead outreach activities for young women to inspire them and empower them to become interested in science and to show them that the skills that they have and have learned from cheerleading and dancing and other non-science activities can greatly benefit them in their science careers.
You also were part of a project that sent bacteria samples to the International Space Station. Tell me the significance of that.
That project was called Project Mercury, which stands for Microbial Ecology Research Connecting Citizen and University Researchers on the International Space Station. I know it's a mouthful. That's why we call it Project Mercury. And ultimately what we did is used citizen scientists. So everyday people who are not professional scientists, they're just interested in science. We used those citizen scientists to help us collect microbe samples, which we then sent to the International Space Station to monitor how they grew in microgravity. A previously undiscovered bacteria was discovered by a cheerleading team who collected it from a stadium bench in South San Diego.
Wow, I love your confidence and how you've never boxed yourself in. What is your advice for people that might be stuck in a rut and think it's too late to change or pursue a new path?
You're not born a science person. You're not born knowing how to walk, or you don't go into cheer practice knowing the routine. That's why your coaches and your instructors are there. They teach you, know that you can do whatever you set your mind to as long as you're willing to put in the work.
Wendy, thank you so much for sharing your pivot story with us. You didn't let stereotypes hold you back and prove that you can be and succeed at more than one thing. Thanks again.
Thank you so much. Thank you for featuring me.
That's our show for today. If you enjoyed this episode of Making Lemonade, you won't want to miss the next one. So hit that subscribe button. I'm your host, Noa Rodriguez-Hoffman. A million thanks for watching.